What's up, folks? In this video, we're going to learn how to properly manage prompts using Jinja templates. And that's super useful when you're writing to the OpenAI API or Claude API, or if you're using local models and you want to organize your prompts so that, you know, instead of just every time rewriting them, you have like a system to use. So let me explain what I mean. Imagine we have here a basic call to ChatGPT. All right. So this is a basic simple script to call ChatGPT. You have your import, you set up your client, you define your function, and then you write up whatever model here you want to use, like GPT-40 mini. I'm going to write this as test Jinja templates, the PI. And then you write your system message, you write your prompt. Maybe you add in some extra information like temperature, you set it to like 0, or maybe you set n to like 3 if you want to have like multiple choices for the output, whatever it is, right? Now, this is all wonderful, but what if instead of every time you go to write this prompt, you could reuse modules of prompts? Meaning, if you always write, you're a helpful research and programming assistant, and that gets a little bit cumbersome. So why not use it from a template that you just apply? So let's do that once, and then let's see what that looks like, okay? So I'm gonna turn first this piece of string into a prompt, into a template, okay? So to do that, first I'm gonna call it system message assistant, all right? And now I'm going to write it first over here, all right? So now we transform this into this variable that we can reuse, etc. We're gonna take this string and we're gonna turn it into a Jinja template. Now, if you don't know what Jinja is a very cool package that allows you to do templates for strings that is like extremely useful, reusable across like things like HTML and all sorts of stuff. It's super useful for managing prompts for large language models like ChatGPT, Claude, Gemini, Llama 3, etc., etc. So all you need to do is install Jinja with like pip install Jinja 2. I already have it installed, so there you go. And then after you've done that, all we're gonna do is we're gonna create a file here, and this file is gonna be called sysMessageTemplate.example.jinja2. You could do it as a text file as well. And now here, we're gonna take this string that we just created and we're gonna put it here. And all we're gonna do here now, folks, is we're gonna turn this into a template and we're gonna make it reusable by integrating a variable inside of the text, maybe meaning something that we can replace with other things. This is a prompt that involves some behavior, right, from the assistant. So we're going to say, okay, you are a helpful, and now here, instead of saying research and programming assistant, I'm going to say assistant expertise. All right, so that's what we're going to do. And now I'm going to go back here, and I'm going to say, okay, I need to now render this string back to the script, which is very simple to do in Jinja. All we need is like 4 lines of code, and I'm going to be cheating and I'm gonna be using a function that I wrote that does that automatically. So now what we get is this render Jinja template. Jinja 2 is the file that we have, right? The system message template example. And then we have assistant expertise, research and programming. Everything looks awesome. And now let's take a look at what this function is. So if I go to Jinja Otus here, folks, what I'm doing over there is essentially just loading up a prompt templates. In this case, I was loading up a prompt templates folder, but let's go directly from the folder name. So those are the two important lines that we would be using in this context. So let's transfer them over here. So this way we don't actually use this that I already did there, and we do like from scratch so that we're clear on what's going on. So this is the template that we're gonna be using, and the template's gonna be rendered, all right? So we're gonna render the prompt, and when we render the prompt, we're gonna set assistant expertise to something. So we're going to set assistant expertise, because assistant expertise, folks, if you remember from the template we just wrote, is the variable that should go inside. Okay. So then that's super simple and easy. So now I don't need this anymore. And now this is our render prompt. And now we can test this out. We need to obviously Jinja 2 import environment and ta-da-da, envis this load, prompt templates folder I'm gonna set to this. So now we have an environment, we got a template from the environment, we gave it the name of the template. And now we have that system message, and we can even print this, folks, so that you see that indeed it is the thing that we were thinking about. So if I run the script, test Jinja template, there you go. We get whatever we want, and we could change this to whatever we want. That's easy, simple, awesome. And now we can integrate this into our call to the model by just coming over here, placing the system message assistant here, and the prompt, which could also be a Jinja template if it was a specific prompt to do a specific thing. We'll see that in a second. So now we can test the full script. What's the weather in Tokyo, whatever. And we run this, and it should run just fine. It can't provide real-time weather updates, it's fine. So it's working, it's amazing, it's super neat. Now, what is the useful thing about using these templates? Because now we're systematic about how we use and reuse our prompts, so we can think about them in terms of modules with variables that optimize them for reuse, which is just really cool, fun, amazing, and interesting. There's so many things here that we can do. One example would be if I come here and I say, okay, let's say I want to summarize, I want to have a summary template, right, that summarizes content in different formats. How we would do that? Well, let's start with writing the template, okay? So I'm gonna save here, I'm gonna say sys message template summary, okay? Dot Jinja 2. And this is just an example that we're gonna be doing. And now I'm gonna write, you are a helpful assistant, whatever. And you take in, let's actually call it, you are a summarization engine, and given some content from the user, you will summarize it into this format. And now we put summary format. So now we can have summaries in different ways, right? Given some content, your summarization engine, and then the prompt is only going to contain the information that we would like to summarize, and we're going to control for the summary format. So let's test this out. So I'm going to write another function here called test summary template. And here I'm getting the template, which is the system message template summary. It's actually not going to be a system message, is it? No, yes. Yes, it is. And now the summary format is going to be what? It's going to be bullet points, all right? So we're going to say bullet points, beautiful. And now I'm not going to be doing this. What I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be making a call to ChatGPT, just like we're doing right here, all right? Just so that we can test this out. And now the system message is actually going to be sys message summary, and the content to summarize. And now the content is summarized, going to be given to this function as an input. And now let's say print test summary templates. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to feed this script as the content to be summarized. Okay. Content to summarize. And now I'm going to put all of that, and I'm going to give the script itself to summarize. And I'm going to put this here, content to summarize. And let's see what happens. All right. Now I'm going to run this. And it should be a summary in bullet points. And that's what we get, folks. And let's say that now we want to change this to maybe not bullet points, but we want a two sentence description. All right. Instead of a summary format. Actually, let's Let's control for summary format, folks. Summary format as another parameter in this function, test summary template. And now here we can put the type of summary that we want, and I want two sentence description. So let's see if that works. There you go. So it works perfectly, and we can now be much more organized in how we get and how we manage and organize the prompts. And you can use that as well as in the ChatGPT interface or Claude interface or whatever you're using, because this is just a place to store your prompts, so you can then retrieve them at will. And there's like a bunch of software that can read Jinja templates and, you know, transform them into whatever you need. So that's what I wanted to do today, folks. This was going to be a quick mid of the week kind of video to show you how to use Jinja templates. I intend to do a little bit more in-depth tutorial on this topic in the future, so stay tuned for that. And thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you next time. Cheers.